1, 2, 3, action. Okay, what is up, guys? Fahan here with Za once again, and today we have Russel. How are you, man?
Hey.
So yeah. Russel is the owner of this KTM Duke. What year is this? I don't mind me asking.
2016.
Wow. And I have to say that when this Duke was first released in the market, it was most popular class to be ever, lah.
Yes, I can say so, because almost like every new riders have this in mind, you know.
Yeah.
The Duke. Mm. At that time, it was one of the popular 2B bikes.
Yes, one of the most popular. And then not only that, at that time, I feel when it's first released, there is not much choices for class 2B riders. Either the FZ, you know, or all those ape bike. Sorry to say lah. No pun intended. I know people get angry or whatsoever. when I say ape bike or orang tua bike. Okay, so before Russel actually tells us the story about his KTM Duke, I'm gonna give a bit of background about it.
Designed, made and launched in 2012 in India by Bajaj Auto, the KTM Duke 200 is a naked motorcycle marketed for city riding with sport capability. Part of the KTM Duke series, the Duke 200 is known for its lightweight and high torque. The chassis and engine are shared with its fully flat cousin, the KTM RC 200. Engine is a 199.5cc liquid-cooled 4-stroke UHC single cylinder with fuel injection and a 6-speed manual transmission. In Singapore, the KTM Duke 200 is a very popular starter bike amongst class 2B riders.
Okay, 1, 2. Okay, so Russel, this KTM Duke is very unique.
Why?
You know why I say unique?
Why?
There's no traces of orange. It's KTM's trademark color. And I have to ask you, as a guy who loves orange,
okay.
Why?
Why? I think, it's not that I hate orange. I think like, just wanted to stand out a bit also lah.
I see.
Because every Duke there is orange or white, right? So just wanted to stand out a bit lah. There's still a bit of orange lah, if you look closely. Got a bit lah.
The stitching on the seat lah. So on the decals on the
rims. Yeah, that's all.
Yeah. And why did you get this KTM Duke as your first bike?
Okay, so I think in the beginning, as you said, a lot of people were normally when they first get 2B, there are a few bikes in mind lah. The common ones like your FZ, you got X Motion, you got XSR, got Duke. All those typical in the street bike class are these few. So I actually went to try around a few different bikes. And out of all the bikes, I realized that this, I'm not a small size guy.
Yeah.
And this bike fitted me a bit more than the other bikes. And then at the same time, other than that, it's one of the most torqueous 2B bikes I felt out of all the ones that I've tried.
Yes, yeah, KTM has this reputation for being very torquey, even though class 2B. Don't mind me asking, what's your height?
I'm 7'8".
So how's the ride for you?
It's okay. So another thing KTM is very famous of, right, is their posture. So it's very weird. So it's divided into two halves. Top half is upright, straight, very similar to an adventure bike. Bottom half is like a sports bike. So you have an upright sitting position. Then your knee right, and your legs right is bent backwards like a sports bike. So like weird lah. Like very weird.
Is it comfortable for you?
For the fun of it, it's not. But for the fun of it, it's worth it lah.
How long have you rode it for? And then what's the price when you bought it? When you first bought it?
I've ridden it for about a year and 3 months. Price that I bought it for was around 8 plus 8 lah.
8 plus. For second hand lah.
Yeah.
You are owner number?
Number 3.
Yeah. So how many years left?
2016.
Six. 2016.
Five and a half.
Okay lah, not too bad lah.
Not too bad lah.
Yeah.
And we can see from the condition of the bike. Yeah.
Okay lah.
It's really well taken care of lah.
Since this is your first bike, Russel,
yeah,
how would you describe its performance? As compared to the previous bike that you mentioned you tried before.
Yeah.
And also the one that in school.
Okay. In school. just for your info, I was from CDC.
Okay.
So it was the YBR 180.
That's
crappy, right? I think that bike is at least 15 years old.
Correct.
Comparing to that, I think there's no competition.
Okay lah. Okay.
But generally, okay, so I've tried the X Motion. I've tried the FZ. I have not tried the XSR. MT15 I've tried.
Okay. So how would you describe its handling? Its performance?
Okay.
Torque.
I would say this bike, right, is a mixture of a few things. So the height is very similar to MT15. is higher than normal bikes. Engine wise, I think, as I was saying earlier, I think 2-speed bikes generally all are, top speed wise, all this kind of stuff, they're all about the same.
Yeah.
There's not much of a difference, lah. I would say the biggest, as I said earlier, the biggest difference is the torque. Yeah, like there's no way of riding this right in a smooth manner one. The engine is not a smooth one. Yeah, it's meant to be like just whack, go gear one, then always like jump up, down, up, down, up, down. Yeah, so other than that, it's just a very, it's all like any other 2-speed bike lah. Performance wise, it's just stockier a bit, taller a bit, that's all.
For as long as you have already owned this bike, has this bike given you any problem? Problems?
Okay, so in the 1 year, 3 months I've had this bike, only problems I had was one. Well, was one day I was I went to the car park. I wanted to ride off. Then I realized, hey, there's a very small pool of oil at the bottom of my bike. Yeah. So then I was like, oh, is this a problem or not? All this kind of stuff. So put in a group chat. People tell me, say, is this. In the end of the day, I decided to go to the workshop. Then I changed the gasket lah.
The gasket is the one that's
So I changed the gasket.
I think that is a common problem for most bikes. After a few years, the gasket wears out.
So it's changed, didn't really cost much. And okay lah.
Other than that, no issues.
Nothing at all.
So, because we did an interview with the KTM 390 guys, they actually shared that KTM bikes are notorious for problems, problematic, high fuel consumption. So, does that actually apply to the 200 as well?
High fuel consumption compared to all my FZ friends, it's like heaven and earth. Heaven and hell, lah. Heaven and hell. Fuel consumption is not very very good for this bike, but then again, trade off, lah. Right? Yeah, you get more fun.
You want speed? You want torque?
It's like Super 4 with VTEC without VTEC. VTEC, feel go up. No VTEC, feel go down. It's the same thing. Like this.
That's why KTM has this nickname. KTM, kuat telah minyak.
Fuel guzzler.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, so fuel consumption, you're saying fuel consumption and problems. Yeah, so fuel consumption is the only problem. But other than that, problems, as I said, it's just the gasket thing, and that's due to wear and tear. Other than nothing.
So, are you in any group? KTM group?
Yeah, in the KTM group.
So do the guys in the group actually share?
Face problems. So KTM, I've never faced this issue, but KTM group, most common issues are the digital
speedometer.
Correct. So this thing, right, very easy to kind of water. And very easy to spoil. So this one just need to take note. Other than that, this bike has a problem of stalling. So I have a friend, same thing, has a Duke also. Actually, I bought a Duke because of him. Then recently his bike, like after right halfway, then will stall. And it's not, I'm not saying that it's very common. It's just that like I've seen it a few times lah in the group chat. Yeah.
So it's an intermittent problem.
Yeah, something like that. But it can be fixed lah.
It's not too serious lah.
No. Okay, yeah.
Speaking of fixing, right, how do you rate the maintenance and the parts, you know, if like you see your bike is accessorized, is it too expensive?
In
terms of accessories, is there a lot?
Okay, so accessories, KTM has their own series, power part series, so you can get those, but it's super expensive. If you can afford it, okay, go ahead, man. And you also got your AM and aftermarket series. Quite easy to get, as you said, you know, a few years back, in the beginning, this was one of the more popular 2B bikes, right?
Yes.
So a lot of workshops actually have a lot of their parts lah. Singapore also has their own like a verified dealer. So it's very easy to get parts. It's just that it costs a bit more lah. They are normal Japanese bikes lah. Other than that, maintenance wise, okay. So maintenance is your standard normal. Normal bikes 2005 or even less, or it's either 2005 or per month lah. Or 2000 or per month, you go and change your engine oil filter, normal kind of stuff. The only difference with this bike and all other like normal street 2B bikes, right, is the number of oil bottles it requires. So FZ, 1 liter.
Correct.
You got X Motion 1 liter, MT 15 all 1 liter, right? This one special. This one give you another half more. So you need one and a half.
One and a half.
Yeah, one and a half.
see.
Yeah. Okay. So same thing, Super 4. VTEC got 4 piston, right? 4 liter, so you cannot lah, you sucked up. You have to do it lah, no choice. Yeah.
Understood.
Sorry, by no means am I comparing this bike to a Super 4. I'm just saying.
So you don't mind me asking, where do you usually go to do your servicing? Like, okay. You go to an Ape shop or you go to any specialized shop?
I go to a specialized shop. It's a Equator Brotherhood lah, if you ever heard of it. Yeah, Equator Brotherhood. Yeah.
So you feel as if they are more versed in the KTM Duke lah.
Yeah. Hmm. But in Singapore there are few lah. Hmm. You got your dirt wheels.
Dirt wheel,
and got one more, I forgot the name. Yeah.
Sorry. It's okay. Just go to workshop you're comfortable with.
With care, yeah. Honest can already.
Talking about accessories, I see that you have done a few customization to your bikes.
Yeah.
Like the seats and the
handguards.
Yeah. What other
small stuff.
Whatever addition to the bike you have done so far.
Okay. Previous owner, what have you got actually?
Okay, so previous owner, I got the exhaust. Got the box and the rack. I got handguards.
Handguards, wow.
Yeah. Other than that, frame sliders.
Frame sliders.
Mm. Yeah, other than that, the rest is all I
own. So the decal where you put ready to race is yours.
So decal.
Domino grip is yours.
Decal, domino grip mine. And shorty lever. Actually this right, previous owner gave me, but I didn't like the colour.
Oh.
And then I bought a brand new one.
I see.
Yeah. Okay. Other than that, all the small little stuff are like the brake reservoir covers.
Mm-mm.
The top cover.
Seat
also previous owner.
You have to comment the seat lah. Woo.
Yeah.
Super comfy. Sedap sia. Oh my god. Kind of. I wish my bed is like this.
So. and then the cover is like.
Yeah.
This one. Premium. Water also.
Yeah. Rebel.
You won't.
You have to keep this away from cats.
Yeah. But this was quite new lah. When I took over, a previous owner just bought. Radiator guard.
Mm-hmm.
I spray paint myself. And then dual horn system. Yeah.
It's louder lah.
Wow, it's very loud.
So this grey colouring.
Yeah.
Is it wrap or is it?
Oh no, it's spray paint.
Wow.
Yeah, spray paint.
You can see it's spray. Is it under your ownership that you spray it?
Yeah, under my ownership. Yeah.
Because he hates orange, guys.
Yeah. No, I don't hate orange. Okay, no, I'm going to get flamed by all the KTM people.
It's okay. Each owner has their preference. At least he kept the orange and the stitching on the seat.
Yeah, and the sticker.
And the sticker.
Yeah.
So, this is something that you cannot take away from KTM. It's trademark orange.
Yeah, orange. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I leave a bit. Still got bleed orange. Yeah.
Yes. And how's the exhaust like?
Okay. Exhaust. The best part of this exhaust, right, to me, right? Let's say you're going around 60.
Uh-huh.
So 60 is around gear 3 lah.
Mm-hmm.
Gear 3. Then clutch in, downshift, engine brake, pop. Then after that, 40, downshift to gear 2, pop all the way. Yeah. So that's one of the best part about this. The best parts about this exhaust.
About the sound. Yeah. Enjoy it.
Yeah, it's
hopefully
fun.
It doesn't annoy the pedestrians though.
Wow. I stress already. I know last time you police, right?
This one nothing to do with police.
Okay.
So in your 1.5 years, right? 1.5 years ownership, what's your best memory with the bike?
Even though I've gotten this bike for quite some time, I haven't really rode much lah. Never really ride a lot. I have a car and I bought the bike honestly and took a 2B license because all my friends were riding bikes and I just didn't want to be left out. So
that's the first.
Yeah, so most fond memory. This one time. Okay, this is one time. Okay. I think 1 month into passing my 2B.
Okay.
And then I was at night I just like wanted to go and ride myself.
Mm-hmm.
To discover the love of riding, right? Yeah. I went to ride out by myself. Then there was these two class 2 bikes.
Yeah.
At that point in time, I didn't know what bikes they were, I can't even remember. Yeah. But I know they were class 2. So these two class 2 bikes fully decked out with all the racing gear and everything. And then I was from far, and then I was approaching the stoplight. So I did the downshift, pop, downshift, pop. Then when I reached the line, it came up with these two very loud pops. Then these two class 2 people both turned their heads, look at my bike, and then was scanning my bike, and then they gave me a thumbs up. Then to me at that point of time, right, I just passed, I got P plate. Then for like this, wow, these two class two people to give me a thumbs up. Oh, oh.
You mean sure. Respect, ah?
Yeah, like respect, yeah. Like wow, respect. Yeah. Okay lah. Yeah, okay, that's my best memories lah. But I mean, other than that, just riding with friends. I mean, the whole reason why I got the bike is honestly to just enjoy the feeling of riding and getting to know people.
Okay, just want to ask you, as compared to driving a car,
yeah.
How would you compare which the experience?
Oh, okay, you have to tell me compare in what sense?
Compare in what sense, like the ride,
the feeling, the sensation,
better, you know, or driving better.
Okay. Sensation, know? Hands down. Last time when I was riding. Driving, I always thought like, oh, yeah, it's so dangerous. Then like, rain also cannot ride, what's the point? That's stupid, all that kind of stuff. I don't understand your logic. Then after that, when my friends all, you know, did it, then I went to lessons, right? And then when I first got on that bike, that YB 150, then I started riding, then I was like, wow, the feeling is so different. so exhilarating. Then after, when I started to ride, and then when I became more adventurous on the road, right, then I was like, wow, this can't be compared to driving at all, man. Can't be driving. Then now I totally understand why people love riding. Totally
it's
understand.
More thrilling, right?
Yeah. More thrilling is when you're, there's this thing, like when you're riding, right?
Winning the face, you know.
You're just in like your own bubble, your own world. Then you got all the time to be alone and think about your things, all this kind of stuff. Yeah.
True.
Yeah. And another thing that I realized also about riding bikes is that people, riders on the road versus drivers on the road. Riders on the road way more friendly, way more willing to help. Drivers right, zero.
Zero.
Correct.
You
get an accident, okay, good luck. Continue on.
Yeah, true, quite true.
The right, very true.
The brotherhood of motorcyclists is very, you know, very
close-knit. Yeah.
Close-knit, you know. Yeah. It's a close-knit community. You see a friend, you see a stranger, accident or bike stall by the roadside, you definitely want to help, you know. Hey, bro, anything I can help you?
Yeah.
Definitely. Because at the end of the day, I believe, this is what I believe. I believe that if you help people at the end of the day, when you need help, people will come and help you. That's why I make it a point. If I see some of our riders, brothers, riders on the road, need help, or by the roadside, stop and ask. If they already call their tow or friends, we can leave. But if they need help, we can help. We help first.
Yeah.
Because who knows, one day you might be in that place.
Yeah.
You also need help.
Yeah.
I guess because it's the nature of cars. Because cars, you're isolated.
Yeah.
You're inside the vehicle by yourself. But here, you're exposed.
Yeah.
So that's why I feel riders are more inclined to brother on the road. So let's say if your friends poison you, ask you go riding to JB or further up
KL,
Thailand.
So, I know.
I want to poison you, bro.
I know. He's in. Would I go?
Would you go?
Of course. As I said, the whole reason why I even took a license in the first place, started riding, was because of friends, ma. Yeah, you know what I mean. So if my friends ask me and I don't go, then what for I take my license for?
Okay, Russell friend. Once the border open, can open. Him up.
Okay,
so final question, Russell. As you know, this bike is a class 2B, and I don't know if any riders who are eyeing on this bike for newbies, would you recommend the KTM Duke 200 for our class 2B riders out there? Anyone in general?
If you want something that is a bit more fun than a normal bike, and you can afford the extra 500 ml of oil, then I would say go ahead, go for it lah. Don't worry about problems. I think every bike has its problems. As long as you get a bike, take care of it properly, everything should be okay. Other than that, okay, you have a lot of fun lah. You get this bike, for sure.
So I want to thank Russell for coming out because I actually saw him at the traffic light. I saw him at the traffic light, then he's like, hey, you're shocked.
Are you Farhan Tre? They lift up the modular. Yes, I'm that guy. Yes, I'm that guy. Then I was with my girlfriend. Girlfriend asked me, who's that? So you don't know who's that? That is Farhan. I immediately show her a video. I didn't tell you that, I immediately show her a video of you almost crying while talking about Hidayah.
Oh man.
I showed her immediately.
I still miss her, by the way. Thank you lah, and thank you for, you know, sharing your ride with us, and approaching us, you know, to do this review. And especially want to thank Mizzy also for being part of the camera crew. Yeah, and then any riders want to review their bike with us, to get in touch with us, do through our social media pages.
Okay, if you guys like this video, like and share with your riding car keys, and don't forget to subscribe to our videos. Okay, if you like this video, click the like button and share with your riding khakis, and don't forget to subscribe to Farhan's channel.
Yeah, and that's it for the vlog, and we will see you next one.